You know when you lock eyes with someone and you start to wonder if your eyes just happened to connect or if she was actually checking you out? How do you know? And what do you do in that situation? What's up everyone, my name is Alex Costa and today I got your back. I've been in that situation so many times and back in the day, I used to fail hard every time this happened. I was too scared to do anything about it and I'd always just tell myself that she wasn't really looking at me. She was just looking in this direction. But we all know that this was just me being a little I learned my lesson, I found the confidence that I needed to go over there and talk to them when that happened, and honestly, it changed my life. And today, I'm gonna tell you what you need to do to take control of that situation when it happens to you. Are you ready? First things first, if you lock eyes, do not, I repeat, do not look away. Hold your gaze and see her reaction because that will tell you everything you need to know. She might look away and make a face, like a mean face, and that means she's probably not into it. Or she might look away but try to act cool, kind of act a little bit embarrassed, and this is a good thing, this is 50-50 for you. Or she might smile, which is the best reaction that you can get here. So you need to hold your gaze, you need to lock eyes and hold it just a little bit longer than you're used to. It's gonna feel a little uncomfortable. Don't stare her down, all right? Don't make it weird. But make sure to get her reaction. And whatever that is, it's going to tell you so much about the way that she feels about it. The next thing you need to do is actually something that you shouldn't do, is hesitating. You cannot hesitate. So if you lock eyes with her, she smiles, don't hesitate to go over there. Don't wait. What are you waiting for? The next moment she looks at you, the next smile, you're not gonna get it. My advice to you is don't sit around and wait. If you lock eyes and if you feel like there's a little bit of a connection there, go over there and talk to her. I've done the waiting thing before. You know, you lock eyes, you see someone, you smile. I'm like, I'm at the grocery store. I'm just gonna get something. And then at checkout, I'll go over there and talk to her. And then you look back and she's gone. You're never going to find her again. And that happens every time, whether you're at a bar, at the grocery store, just walking outside. Go over there, do not wait. On the way over there, this is the next tip for you guys, is you should be analyzing the situation really well. Now, what does it mean to analyze the situation? It means scan the room. See who she's with, what she's doing, what she's wearing. Analyze and process all of that information as fast as possible because that's going to help you with your opener. If she's wearing some workout gear, for example, you can use that excuse to start a conversation with her. Hey, I think I recognize you from my fitness class yesterday. Probably not. It's a little bit of a lie, but you know what? It's gonna get the conversation started. If you're at a bar, you look at her, she's having a weird, fruity, very feminine drink. You can go over there, tease her for it, make fun, as long as it's all fun and games and you're not being annoying. So analyzing the situation is gonna give you the opportunity to go over there and start with your opener, give you some ammunition so that you can start talking to her. The next thing is don't try to act so cool, like the cool guy. And what this means is, don't go up to her and start trying to prove yourself. Don't start to, this happens all the time here in LA. Sometimes I eavesdrop, it's the fun. It's like a really fun thing to do when you're out and you're just listening to a guy trying to hit on a girl and you're just like, what are you doing, my man? What are you doing? A lot of the guys here just go up to girls and they start the conversation by telling them about their job. Oh, I make money, I drive this type of car, I have this type of watch. Come on guys, there's so many things that you could talk about. Don't try to be so cool and prove yourself in front of her right away. It makes you look douchey, it makes you look like you're trying so hard, and you sound like every other guy that tries to hit on her. I actually like the opposite approach. I like being very, very humble, just being honest and down to earth, and that is such a breath of fresh air for most girls that they're going to really like and enjoy spending time and talking to you. Now, don't confuse this with talking down on yourself, making fun of yourself. Sometimes that works to break the ice, but at the same time, make sure that she knows that you're the man. Next up, guys, if you're going over there to talk to her, there's one thing that you need to keep in mind at all times, and that is your final goal. And what is it? You have to set it before you even go there. Is it to get her digits, to get her Instagram? You have to know that, otherwise you don't know if you did okay or if you failed that situation. Basically, as you're walking there, as you're analyzing the situation, scanning the room, think, hey, all I want right now is to get her phone number and then I'm gonna text her and we'll see if we can hang out later. Or hey, all I want right now is to get her Instagram, make sure we follow each other so that we can have a conversation later. Or you can walk up to her and your goal may be, I'm gonna buy her a drink, we're gonna sit next to each other and chat and see where it leads to. Having a goal makes it so much easier because you can really set the conversation to lead up to that goal. For example, if you're on her phone number, then you can start talking about something related to your phone, then pull up your phone, and then all of a sudden makes it a lot easier for you to ask about her phone number. And of course, guys, when it comes to approaching another person, you have to be okay with rejection.
That is just how it works.
You have to be okay with rejection because it just happens all the time and you never know why it's happening. Most of the time, it's not even you. Because maybe she just broke up with her boyfriend, she doesn't really want to talk to anyone right now, or she has a boyfriend, or she's having a girl's night out and she doesn't want to talk to anyone. The interesting thing about rejection is the more you get rejected, the less it matters, the less it stings and cuts you. So get rejected, you know, and then once that happens, move on to the next person. That way you're not wasting your time with someone who's clearly not ready. Guys, I want to play a little game and I want to hear your worst rejection story. Let me know in the comments section down below and I'd love to hear it so that we can chat in the comments. Of course, don't forget to follow me on Instagram. It's @AlexCosta. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you again very, very soon. Peace.